In the light, we said before that one of the properties of the light is how the light transmits or passes through the different objects. And we said that we have three types of objects. We said that we have transparent, semi-transparent or translucent, and opaque. Transparent is the one like glass where the light, all of it passes through the transparent object, and the semi-transparent, we said that it passes some light, and the opaque, we said it doesn't pass any light. Okay, like your book, for example. So, when I'm talking about how can I see colored objects, I have two ways that I can see colored objects. The first one, we are going to talk about the transparent. The semi-transparent together. This is number one. And number two, we are going to talk about the opaque objects. So again, how can I see colored objects? I have two types of objects, or they are three, but I will take the transparent and the semi-transparent together. So the transparent and the semi-transparent, I can see them in the same way. But the opaque has a different way. Let's see together. First of all, let's talk about the transparent and the semi-transparent. For example, if I have a red if it's transparent or semi-transparent, okay? It will take all the seven spectrum colors when the white light falls on it. It will take them, which means it will absorb them, take them in it, and it's a little bit selfish, so it will only allow its color to pass. Again, it will take all the colors in it, and it will only allow its own color to pass. So, we have red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet. All of them will keep inside the bottle. Which one will pass? Because it's transparent, so it allows the light to pass. It will allow only its red color to pass, so the red color will pass. So I will see it in red color. My eye is over here, so I will see it in red color. This is my eyes. So again, how do I see it in the red color? Because the bottle is selfish and its color is already red. How it's red, this is not my problem. My problem here is how do I see it red? How does my eye see it red? When the white light falls on the bottle will take, absorb all the right colors and allow only its red color to pass. Why? Because it's selfish. Let's take another example. This bottle is green. Which color will pass? Only the green will pass. So if this bottle was green, transparent or semi-transparent, the bottle will absorb all the light colors and allow only its green color to pass. Okay? If it's blue, it will absorb all the light colors and allow only the blue color to pass. So according to the color of the bottle, it will pass its same color. If it's red, it will pass red. If it's yellow, it will pass yellow, and so on. This is only in the case of transparent and semi-transparent. I still didn't start talking about the opaque. So here, what happens? That in the transparent and semi-transparent, how do I see it in this color? Because it allows all light colors to pass.
With its seven
spectrum colors. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay? How do I see red? Let's say my eye is over me. This is my eyes. How do I see red? The paper will absorb, it will take. It's also selfish, like the bottle, but there's a small difference. It will also take all the light colors, but it will not allow it to pass its color because it's not transparent, it's opaque, so the light can't pass. So what will it do? It will reflect only its own color. So again, when the white light falls on a red paper, the red paper will absorb, it will take all the light colors, and it will reflect only its own color. Why doesn't it allow the light to pass? Because it's opaque, so the light doesn't pass. Like for example, this paper, it doesn't pass the light. As you can see, you can't see it because the light can't pass, okay? So, because it doesn't allow the light, what will it do? It will reflect only its color. So I will see it in the red color. Let's say for example, if this paper is orange, what will happen? It will absorb all the light colors and it will reflect only its own color, which is the orange. Let's say another example, if it's violet, what will it do? It will absorb all the light colors and it will reflect only its own color. Concentrate very well on the difference between this and this. Here we said absorb and allow. Here it will be absorb also, but we will change the second step, which is reflect, not allow because it is opaque. So again, it will absorb all light colors, and will it allow? No, it will reflect only its own color. Clear? So I said step number one, absorbs all the light colors. Step number two, reflects all the light color. Why does it reflect, not allow? Because it is opaque, so the light can't pass. This part is very important. Know very well the difference between the opaque color and the transparent and the semi-transparent, which are colored. The transparent and the semi-transparent absorbs and then allows. This is step number two. It absorbs and then allows. Here it absorbs and then it reflects the color. So I can ask you a question, for example, give me reason why the red sheet, for example, or the green sheet appears green. Green opaque sheet appears green. Why? So if I'm asking why, I know that the green sheet is opaque, so I will say because it absorbs all the light colors and then reflects its green color. Okay? The other part of the opaque are the black and the white, and I want you to concentrate very well on this part, the black and the white.
Black is the sign of evil and the white is the sign of angels and good things.
is that when the white light falls on the black sheet, like this, what will happen? It will absorb all the light colors and then nothing. It will only absorb. It's very selfish, so it will absorb all the light colors, keep them inside it, so I will see black. Again, the black is very selfish, so it will take, absorb all the light colors, and it will not do anything else. It will only take them, and it doesn't want to leave anything. That's why I will see black. So what happens in the black? It absorbs all light colors. Absorbs all the light colors. Until here it's clear? Okay. Let's see what happens in the white, which is like an angel. Take very good care that we are talking about a big object. So here I took step number one and I said that the black absorbs. I want you to think, what do you think the white sheet will do when the white light falls on it? What will it do? It's very kind. So the kind thing, what does it do? It takes or it gives? Of course it gives all the colors. So when the white light falls on a white sheet, the white sheet will reflect all the light colors falling on it, and when it reflects them, this is like mixing them together. And I said in the beginning of the lesson that when I mix the light colors together, this will make what? This will give me what? It will give me the white light, and that's why I see the sheet in the white color. So again, when the white light falls on the white object, it will not absorb any color, it will reflect all the light colors, reflect all the light colors, and when they are reflected, they are mixed together, so I see it in the white color. So what does the white sheet do? It reflects all light colors. So I see the object in the white color. So if I ask you, why do I see whatever, anything in its white color? Because it reflects all the light colors. Why do I see, for example, this in its black color? Why do I see it black? Because it absorbs all the light colors. Okay? So, very quickly again, we said that seeing colored objects, I have two types of objects, transparent and semi-transparent, are together as if they are one thing, they do the same thing, and the opaque. The transparent and the semi-transparent, I said that when the white light with its seven spectrum colors fall on the object is transparent or semi-transparent, so it will take, absorb all the light colors, and it will allow only its own color to pass, whatever its color is. And the opaque, I have three cases. I have colored objects, I have black, and I have white. If the object is colored, it will absorb all the light colors. Will it allow? No, of course it will not allow because it's opaque. So instead it will reflect its own color only, whatever its color is. Red, orange, or yellow, or green, or blue, or indigo, or violet, it doesn't matter. And we have the other two cases, which are the black and the white colors. What will happen in them? The black, it's very selfish and evil, so it will take, absorb all the light colors, and it will give me nothing, so I will see it black. Double white, the white is like an angel, so it's very good, so it will reflect all the light colors. Okay, so here I have two steps, absorb and then allow. Here I have absorb and then reflect, and the last two, one will absorb only and one will reflect only. Okay, so I wish until here everything is clear. This is how I see the different objects in their colors, with their different types. see the colored objects, okay? So, we are going to start a new part in our lesson, which is the colored lights, okay? I have two types of colored lights. So, the colored light is divided into two groups. Primary light colors, primary light colors, and secondary light colors. So I have the primary light colors and the secondary light colors. From the word primary, primary means that they are like as if they are number one or the main colors. Okay? Why do I call them the main colors? Because the primary light colors are the colors that when I mix them together, they give, what do they give me? They give me white light. This means that the primary light colors work as the seven spectrum colors. Okay, so again, I have primary light colors and secondary light colors. The primary light colors, from the word primary means the main light colors. Why do I call them the main? Because when I mix them together, they give me the white light. So they work as the seven spectrum colors. What are the primary light colors? They are three colors. They are how many? They are three primary colors. What are they? They are red, green, and blue. So again, what are the primary light colors? Red, green, blue. They are only three primary colors. So I have three primary colors, red, green, blue. If I mix the red and the green and the blue colors together, they will give me what? They will give me the white light color. So they work as the seven spectrum colors. These are the primary light colors. Let's see what are the secondary light colors. From the word secondary, we feel as if we are saying this is number two. Why do we call them secondary? Because they are formed by mixing what? Two primary light colors. What does this mean? This means now, if I take any of the two primary colors and I mix them together, they will give me the secondary light colors. Let's take an example. If I take the red with the green, what will happen? Red plus green will give me what? Yellow color. This means that this is the secondary color. Yellow color is the first secondary color we have. Let's take another example. If I mix the green with the blue, what will happen? Green with the blue, it will give me which color? It will give me a color which is called cyan. The color is called what? It's called cyan. What is cyan? This is the cyan color. This is the cyan. This is the cyan color, which we call it turquoise. It's a color between the green and the blue. Okay? The last thing we are going to take, we said red and green, and then we took the green with the blue. So again, I have also three secondary colors. Number one is the yellow color, number two is the cyan, number three is the magenta. So what are the secondary light colors? They are colors formed by mixing. By mixing what? By mixing two primary colors. Can I form the primary colors by mixing the secondary colors? Of course not. The primary are the main colors. When I mix three primary together, which are red, green, and blue, they give me the white light. What is the difference between the primary and the secondary? The secondary comes from the primary. I can't have the secondary alone, no. The primary, they are already present, they are here. What do I do to get the secondary? I mix two primary together. When I mix them, they give me the three secondary light colors. Red with green will give me yellow. Green with blue will give me cyan. Red and blue will give me magenta. Miss, do I have to know this? Of course you have to know this. Well, I can ask you a question complete. Green and dots color gives me cyan. Which color? Blue. Okay? Blue with what gives me magenta? Red and so on. So you have to know what are the two primary colors that I mix and what do they give me. And I have to know that the secondary light colors are yellow, cyan, and magenta. So I can ask you a question. The secondary light colors are dots and dots and dots. So you have to write the three of them. So you have to know that the same idea in the primary. You have to know that the three primary colors are red, green, blue. Because I can ask you, what are the primary colors? They are red, green, blue. Or I can ask you, they are the colors that are, when I mix them together, they give me white light. What are the primary colors? So again, if I ask you, for example, give me the scientific term. They are the colors that when I mix them, they give me white light. Don't tell me red, green, blue. I want you to tell me that they are primary. If I tell you the primary colors are dots and dots and dots, you will tell me red, green, blue. So you have to memorize what are the primary, that they are the colors that when I mix them together, they give me white light, and what are the secondary, they are colors that are formed when I mix two primary colors, and you have to know each of them, the red and the green and the blue are primary, yellow, cyan, and magenta are secondary. Okay? So these are the two different types of light colors, primary and secondary. Red, green, blue are the primary, yellow, cyan, and magenta are the secondary. I wish you understood the lesson and try as much as you can to study well, and I will